Now you've got the world title, the IBF world title. Is this it for you? Is this like, oh, maybe I was an amateur, I'm a pro, I'm a champion. Is this it? Is it over for you now?
No, it's kind of funny. I mean, when I started pro, I mean, that was my goal. Now that I accomplished it, it's like, I mean, I'm a world champion. Everybody around me, like, enjoys more than I do. I'm still hungry, you know?
Still hungry? You think this is getting spotted?
Yeah, I mean, I know I accomplished something, but that was, in that moment, I'm excited, and I was excited, but it's not like you say. I mean, I'm like, I'm world champion, I'm gonna cool down, I'm gonna think I'm better than you. No, it's not like that. I mean, I'm gonna enter the ring, like, if I'm hungry to become a new champion, you know? I'm a champion right now, but I want to defend it, like, I was fighting to get it.
Right.
I cannot think that my opponent is gonna be an easier opponent or nothing. I mean, I have the same game plan and the same mentality that I had when I first talked to the world title.
So you still feel humble? Your title didn't change?
You feel humble? Yeah, that's it.
So you think later on down the road you might change your weight class?
Of course, I mean, that's
to get more
belts? That's the most. I mean, I used to fight as an amateur at 118. At 119, I'm sorry. I went and the squarehouse at Texas.
Now what is this Filipino thing? I think you're going to defend the title with another Filipino.
Yeah,
is it one for Philippines?
Yeah, it's going to be my third fight in a row with a Filipino. I guess there's a lot of Filipinos out there.
You're in your weight class at this moment. How many fights do you have as an amateur?
Like around 120.
Are you moving to the Philippines soon to defend your title? Is that what's going to happen soon?
I hope I don't. It went to Subata.
They're still talking about the contract.
Subata already went to a press bid.
A bid.
And a promoter won the bid. And he wants to take it to Philippines. But he has, according to the paper he wrote out, he has 2 months to decide, but he put on the paper list. He's thinking of May 2, and I think that's like a far away date. So
okay.
I was told by my people that they're trying to work things out to make it in USA.
Yes, I think so.
Because
I feel better about that.
There was already an agreement by both sides that they were going to pay him a amount of money, they were going to pay me a amount of money, everything was okay. But the IBF organization was getting like, hey, you gotta make that fight happen. So they pressured a little for this first bid. And this guy went to make the first bid, but legally, if IBF says you gotta do it,
right.
I was told that you have a Washington, and you're Washington, and there's an agreement, there's a real deadline for the fight.
Right.
We can fix it. They can fix it.
You do have a time limit to defend your title. Is that correct?
Yes, but I'm fighting the mandatory, but he's still number 3. He's not the number 1 mandatory. He's the mandatory, but he's not the number 1 mandatory. So that's what we
do. The twin brother of the world champion, the IBF title champion, Mcwilliams and Mcjoe. He is also my cousin. We look alike, right? But the only thing that these guys have from me is not the boxing skills, because we're boxing in 2 different areas. I was boxing San Juan while they were boxing in Pajanto. But they have one thing. Looks. That's what I told everybody. We all look good. But I want to ask you, Mcwilliams, now that you see that your brother has a world title, how do you feel about it and what you going to do now? Are you going to step up to the...
You guys are going to a different country. I get concerned and worried because you are my blood. And I don't want to see my brother going to a different country, either getting hurt or having the referees choosing their guy. And that happens a lot. What happened in Thailand? What do you think happened?
I'm not there with excuses. I know it was a close fight. He got the decision. No, that's what happened. I passed the pace. I knew that if the ever see the fight or saw the fight, they could agree or disagree or have some opinions. I know that some things that I know wouldn't have happened if it was over in the United States or a different country.
Exactly.
Happened in Thailand. But you know, I'm a man. It happened. And, speaking to working out in the gym, and hopefully I'll give him a shot.
Those are very humble words. You have led it in the past. But like I said, you know, I wish that you guys have more fights here in the United States or Puerto Rico and not in other countries where these things might happen.
Well, you know, we made a decision to win for the championship. Something that happened, you know, it's all about experience. We already know that not only it's hard to go over there, you know, go overseas, eat, you know, different kind of food, the time zone is totally different, you know, but it's an experience. We may only find a fair agreement yet. Only if I sign it, you know, we'll talk about it, but definitely I want to shout out to any of the world champions.